Hello everyone, my name is Anwar Akbayev, glad to see you on my channel by Akolto. I'm not a native speaker, so please do not judge me harshly. Welcome to my biology course. This course is intended for students preparing for such a razor serious exam. Namely, during this course, we will purposefully prepare for SAT biology. Nevertheless, it's worth noting that you can use this course to prepare for various Olympiads, for any other exams. After all, the essence of biology itself doesn't disappear. And so, let's begin our lesson, Introduction to SAT Biology. The first thing to clarify is the course material. I will use four books, Barnes, Kaplan, Princeton, McGraw-Hills. The main material will be from Barnes, because this book is more specific and provides a very good basis for passing the exam. While other books will be only as additional sources, which will add extra information. The second aspect is the exam format. Surely, you have already been looking for information, but repeat doesn't hurt. It's even possible that many of you haven't read about this exam in more detail. To begin with, I think we need to explain why SAT biology is needed. In general, this is an exam that's taken for admission to English-speaking universities. At the time of delivery, you will have 100 questions. However, you will only need to answer 80 of them. You may ask, why is this so? This is all because you have the opportunity to choose a section of biology that is closer to you, namely ecology or molecular biology. Also, a very common question is, during registration, do we need to mark the sections that we choose on the test day? When registering, you will not need to mark which of the special sections you choose. In other words, you have the opportunity on the test day to fill in the section on the answer sheet that was given to you more easily. Thus, the structure of the questions is as follows. 60 core questions plus 20 ecology or 20 molecular biology questions, where core questions cover all biology topics, including ecology and molecular biology. The third thing is the approximate number of questions. On this table, you can see the percentage distribution of five main sections, depending on the special section you have chosen, whether ecology or molecular biology. As you can see, they are marked here as E-test and M-test. Thus, this exam includes all sections that differ only in the amount of a couple of questions. For this reason, it's very important to know all the topics very well for successfully passing through this biology test. The fourth thing I would like to dwell on is a test score. And so, your work is evaluated using 800 point scale, where the minimum score is 200 and the maximum is 800 points. For example, I scored 790 out of 800 possible, which is about a couple of questions that were incorrectly noted. Also, it is worth noting that your one correct answer becomes invalid if you mark four questions incorrectly. I would also like to pay attention to a rather important question that students often have when preparing. Leave blank answer options, or is it better to fill? In my opinion, it is better to build on the number of questions that you didn't answer and take into account all the risks of loss or vice versa to obtain additional points. For example, suppose I have four unanswered questions left, and I'm sure that I noted all the remaining 76 correctly. Then I decided to mark all four questions as approximately as possible, because I know that the risk of losing a point isn't great. That is, in the worst case, it will be only 1 point. And so, let's move on to the following recommendations for you during this course. First, required activities. Take notes during and after classes, do practice exams, and repeat all of the covered materials. Second, start a new notebook. Third, practice exam policy. Be strict to yourself, recheck yourself before submission, and be careful. Read every word correctly. Fourth and fifth. This applies more to my students. If you want to deal with me, then write to me in the email. I will leave a link to this below in the description. Finally, our objective is to achieve biological thinking. It can be described as a type of critical thinking where, using the basic principles and knowledge of biology, you will easily answer the biology-related questions. So, this is where our first lesson ended. I will leave the links to download the mentioned books and the slide of today's lesson in the description of this video. I hope it was the most useful for you. I would like to ask you to like, subscribe and share this channel with your friends. I will be waiting for you all in the next lesson. Всем большой рахмет!